This is insane.
Oh my goodness!
Welcome to Da Nang. With the Lady Buddha. So this is our first stop. This is the temple.
And you can go all the way to the top, I believe. And it's free to come in here.
The Buddha. And now you have luck for the rest of the year. It's actually surprisingly very cool in here, like temperature-wise. Okay, I guess it's locked.
So that's disappointing. I was hoping to go all the way up.
Look at the leaves. Yes, it is real. And this is the sleeping Buddha. This is how big he is compared to me.
Much more crowded over here. It's like a zoo here. It's a little bit disturbing. And here is one temple.
So I believe there is this statue or a smaller version of this statue in Banang Hill. And it is massive. That is the base and it's a house that you could actually visit. Huge. I think now is probably the best time to go and take a picture of her from the front. There we go. This is the shrine for her. So if you have something you want to pray for, you usually come to this type of places and you would just pray. If only everything could be solved with praying. So we will leave our shoes here. We are gonna go to Marble Mountains. So I will see you there. Bye. The Marble Mountains is closed, so we're gonna go tomorrow. So now we are in the local market. Souvenirs or whatever you need to buy. So typically you want to come here when they're about to be closing because they want to sell before they leave, either really early in the morning because they're superstitious or very late before they close. Then you have the best deal. That's pretty wild. So frustrating. Everything is closed. I'm Bungtik Nuoc.
So this is Bungtik Nuoc. Very common Vietnamese dish. You just have to put two in.
This is the only place in Vietnam that I see so far that you could use the walking sign. Everywhere else, you just have to make a run for it or walk slowly for it. But this one, you actually wait for the sign. Out of cash, so I'm going to show you how easy or hard it is to get cash from the ATM. All of the banks are closed today on Saturday, so we're going to use this ATM. If you're here and you need to withdraw a crap load of money, wait for a bank to open and then go inside and withdraw. That way you don't have eyes on you out here. This is the RA Bank ATM. This is actually my first time using an ATM in Vietnam. Usually I'm pretty good at budgeting, but this time I bought too many gifts and went too many places. So now I'm out of cash and now I only have like one day left. So I'm gonna put in our card. So I'm getting $200 out. Would you like another transaction? No. I'm getting my card back and nothing is happening. Okay, so this one is a bus. So basically it's saying TP Bank will give you the 5 million withdrawal. Yes, I could probably withdraw a million there, but I don't want to go to like 5 different banks to get 5 million. And then I owe like $20 in withdrawal fee. We're going to try to cross this road. It's very busy. That person is very nice. He stopped. So usually people don't stop, but then now they're a little bit nicer here. You won't be getting that in Hanoi and Saigon.
So we're gonna go in here and try.
This is TP Bank. Oh, there's someone in there. Perfect. So I'll try the ATM first. If not, then I will go in there. Processing. Yes, I hear the money and the cash. Look at this. Nice. So I got the cash. Now we're not broke anymore. I feel better having cash. So this is how crowded it is during the day here. Oh my goodness, they even have this. So this is where you're gonna have the best Vietnamese food, but you're probably gonna have your worst stomach ache. So I need to buy a flip-flop since I left mine in Hoi. These are straw flip-flop. I wish I had more time here. This is why you don't procrastinate till the very end to do things. Mục cha ai bao nhiêu vậy chị? So this is jargon. So this is the exterior of the market. We are at Nuoc Han Sung. It's also known as Marble Mountains. There is a lot of hiking here that you could do. We're gonna go up to this cave. So it is 20,000 per person to get into here. Là bao nhiêu một vé?
20,000.
Cho em một cái này được không?
Dạ, cái này là cái sơ đồ em đóng 15,000.
My mom, I'm going with my family. They're like, it's too much walking. Let's take the elevator. That's where the elevator takes you to another place so you can see all of this if you take the elevator. Look how beautiful this is. We are inside one of the main caves. A lot of offering in here. Man-made pond in the middle of this cave. We're gonna go up that stairway, see what's up there. Long hike all the way up there. My straw flip-flop is not gonna make it after this. This is insane. So the stairway is quite narrow. You can go down and it's a very steep drop. Really, it's beautiful. Look at this. So beautiful, isn't it? It's crazy. So now we're in the pathway to hell. Or we're descending to hell. So creepy. The rock is like so slippery. Oh, this is not creepy at all. No, no, mm-mm. Yeah, at least nothing is like chasing me. So, you know, that's pretty good. Hồi chuẩn bị đường về không? It's like the torture of hell down here. We are gonna go try to find our way out. Why would they make this into like a very creepy cave? Why? Why couldn't it be like fairies and angels and nice things to look at? Why does it have to be creepy? This cave is already creepy. The story of this place is from a Chinese mythology of the Monkey King. No, it's not King Kong. So this is where Buddha imprisoned him for, was it 1,000 years? 5,000 years? A very long time. So this is what this mountain is based on. The guardian of hell. And these are your judge and juror. These guys would probably determine your faith in hell. So there are 5 mountains here that you could explore. So you could pretty much spend your whole day here if you want to, but we don't have all day. I need to go to Hoi An. So we're gonna rush through. So I recommend at least spending half a day here or a full day if you like hiking. We are leaving this cave. You know, I honestly regret not planning to be here better because my parents, I plan to be here for like 4 or 5 days, but they don't want to be here for 4 or 5 days, so now we only have 2 days to do everything.
So you can take the elevator to go up.
So you have to buy it here to use that elevator up there. So it's 55,000 to use the elevator to go up. And then if you want to use the elevator to go down, you have to buy another ticket. For your convenience, there is an ATM there. You could get a tour guide here. The elevator going up, no AC. So another temple, like the one from yesterday. So I would probably go to the one from yesterday, it's free. And you see the view of the beach here. Beach. All of these are made from marble. The important question is, did they build a restroom? And I don't think so. What is the difference between a shrine and a temple? A temple is where people go to worship, and a shrine is remembrance, I'm guessing? I don't know. I'm just BSing. I believe this is the main Buddha. How can you tell? He's always sitting in this huge lotus, and he's pretty bigger than everyone else. So the cave, I think, is a little bit cooler and cheaper. Cooler, literally cooler. Just the map of all the places you can go in here. And the one, oh, I've got it. We're not gonna have time to go all the way to this one. I'm so disappointed. This whole place is huge up here. You can probably spend half a day just hiking around. So we are gonna go take the elevator down because we don't have time to hike down. We're gonna say bye to Marble Mountain. And we're gonna move on to Hoi An. We're gonna go to the coconut boat, and then later this afternoon, we're gonna go do a little bit shopping and then see the memory show. So it's a long, long day. So we have to wait for this taxi to come and move so we can get out. So if you go with a shuttle, that big shuttle, more than 7 seats, you have to take this cart thingy to go into Hoi An walking district. The only time they can go in here is 1 p.m. to 5 p.m. And it's 10,000 to get into, or per person to use this thingy. But if you have like a car that's less than 7 seats, then you can drive through here. So when you go to Vietnam, the best number is 6. 6 or 3, because you can get around very easily that way, versus going with more than 6, then you have to use all these different type of service because there are road restrictions. Đi tới ba mươi một nguyện hoàng nhan. We will eat at this restaurant.
Hello.
Mẹ người ăn. So this is the cell. Interesting.
Let's try this.
So there are different places where you could book the ticket from, so it's a little bit confusing if you book it ahead of time because all of these places would have like different booking. Come you. Okay, my turn.
No,
ah. Very fashionable. Yeah. My mom is so extra. Look how crowded. We'll be right back.
Dân 2 bay gì á?
2 bay hả? Đây hả?
Ở quả đây chơi là có 1 bay
hả? Oh my god. Wow, that was dizzy. So that cost 100,000 to do, and it's really dizzy. Like you can't even put your head up. You just have to like focus and just stare without puking. For people with motion sickness, I don't recommend doing that. There's gonna be dinner tonight. So this is quite an experience. So if you're in Hoi An, I kind of recommend coming here. It's kind of fun. Now we're just waiting to go up. Come on, you. This is Hoi An. Interesting alleyway for this coffee shop. But it's very popular, so we will see. I'm surprised how popular it is, but it's so hidden from the street. It is pretty hidden. Cute little cafe shop. This is the night market. Này là chị làm bao lâu?
Đây là 15.
15 phút hả?
Là cái bự này.
À, và xong mình bỏ vải vô.
Không, cái mình dán vải thôi, còn cái không làm lâu đó.
À. Rồi, cảm ơn chị nha. Cái này là mình in sao?
Vải thì có sẵn hết rồi.
À, làm một cái là bao nhiêu lâu?
Phải làm cỡ 40 phút.
40 phút hả? How beautiful this is. Oh my goodness. So pretty at night. So I verbally reserved a boat to take us to the show. And originally she wanted 300 for 7 people, but I got it down to 200. So now we're gonna see if she's still here. So let's find our person that I reserved the boat with. So I found her and we are gonna go on the boat. So beautiful, oh my goodness. Yeah, I could spend a few days here. So this is gonna be a boat. Yeah, come on, Kinyo. How beautiful is this? Oh my goodness. So beautiful. Don't blow out. More YouTube subscriber. Just kidding. Go! Be free! Go, go, go! Go, go, go! So pretty! Less crowded. Welcome to Hoi An. Mm-hmm. quite interesting. It's about the history of Hoi An. I think it's like half history and half fairy tale. But it's a nice storyline, even if you don't understand what they're saying or singing. If you're in the area, it's worth checking out. Tickets can be around $20 to $25 for eco, and then there's a high level, and then there's a VIP. But honestly, you just need the eco. Super crowded, crazy. I'm gonna go into this really pretty bamboo restaurant. Look how pretty it is. Very pretty. And that is it for Hoi An. I will see you at the beach tomorrow in Da Nang. It's kind of bittersweet, but I'm glad we ended with this show tonight. Welcome to Da Nang Beach. So when I talk to people about Da Nang, I compare it to Malibu in California, and now they actually have a sign that says Malibu. How cool is that? I will pinpoint the location of this beach. It's a little bit further than where the main city is. Not that much further, it's just about half a mile or so. This is durian, the stinky fruit. So of course I have to film this in Vietnam. This was recommended. This is the restaurant, right on the beach. Not the prettiest beach, but it is right on the beach. You have to try seafood when you're here because you're right on the beach. So of course the seafood is gonna be really, really fresh and good. So many, many different types of seafood. I will eat you, I'm sorry, but you're so good looking. Shrimp! Have you ever seen live shrimp in the US? No. I love prawn salad. I'm sorry, I have to eat you all. Maybe not all of you, but some of you. Isn't that crazy? It's like rows and rows of this up there. What is he doing? Oh, he's getting something. No, don't eat me. This is why I can't be a vegetarian or a vegan, because I love seafood too much. I could give up beef, pork, chicken, all of that, but I can't give up seafood. This is the menu. Okay. Là làm cá xì dầu với thêm cá lẩu á, là con nào ngon? Yeah.
Bao nhiêu người?
8 người.
8 người.
Yeah. Là một nửa làm xì dầu, một nửa làm cá lẩu.
Một cái lẩu.
Một lẩu với thêm một cái xì dầu gì đó.
Rồi.
Này wait it.
Một cái tám này, 250 một ký.
So the way that they do this, making sure my mic is on, you pick the fish or seafood you want, and then they weight it, and then they charge you based on the weight of whatever it is. This is durian. This is the inside of it. Really funny story, when we were buying this and I forgot to film. You know, this is my weight, so they take the whole thing and then they weight it. And all of them, the weights was off by almost 4 pounds. If you're in the more touristy era, the weight scale will be a little bit off, especially if they're selling to foreigners. So that's how they kind of cheat you on it. So just be very careful. So when you go to Vietnam and they bring this type of food out, it's not free. They're gonna charge you if you eat it. So just be aware of that. This is the clayfish. Comparison, this is my hand, and this is how big it is. And that's it for Da Nang in Hoi An. I hope you enjoyed this video, and I see you in America. Bye.
Thank you for watching. Until next time.